Hi, welcome to My Chow Line. I'm Tracy Lingle. Today we're doing a special series on dessert. We're just going to do the dessert this time around. Should be fairly short and simple. It's not a long cook, but we're going to do what I'm known for around the community of Round Canopy Parachute Team, cobbler. I'm going to be doing an apple cobbler, and these are technically called a dump cobbler in a Dutch oven. This is a Camp Dutch oven, a 14-inch Cabela's Dutch oven. So you notice, unlike a home Dutch oven, this lid has a lip around it, and it has the legs. So that way, you can put coals underneath it and coals on the lid, and they don't go anywhere. So this is basically replaces an actual oven like you would use in your house. So anything you could cook in your oven at home, you can cook inside this. Using charcoal on top and charcoal on the bottom, you can regulate the temperature, you can braise in it, you can set this on top of a stove to, you know, cook things on it and then put it down and put coals on top of it to heat it up, keep it warm, all that kind of stuff. So we're going to start with cutting up our apples and getting those ready. We're going to saute those down a little bit, and we'll get to it. So we'll get everything set real quick and get it all prepped. Be back in a second. All right, so we're going to dice up these apples, and we're going to get them in the bowl, get them ready to saute. I like cutting them by hand. You can use one of those cores, but I think if you do that, you still have to cut them into small. I like nice thin pieces. You can also peel them if you want. I like the texture of the skin myself, but not everybody does. I sometimes will mix in cans of pie filling, apple pie filling, along with fresh apples as well, depending on how big a pot you're trying to make, to make it go a little further. It also adds extra sweetness because the apples themselves aren't super sweet. But when we're going to caramelize them down with some brown sugar and butter, and it'll make them nice and sweet. But that's basically what the pie filling is. It's just already canned. So if you're in a hurry or you need a lot of it, I like to add fresh for, in fact, I'll probably set aside a few of these to put in with the sauteed ones, so that way you get some crunch, but you also get the soft, ooey gooey, melt in your mouth apples as well. And I like doing them pretty thin, that way they cook up a little faster. They don't have to be all the same thickness, but you want to try to keep them fairly consistent. And this is just my way of doing it. You can do it your way, however you like it. But this is how I do it. So I'm going to do these up, and then we'll get back in just a second. All right, so I've had to modify my grill a little bit by taking the center grate out and kind of using the ones on the side to support the Dutch oven. I'm using this to do the sauteing of the browning down of the apples and the butter and the brown sugar, and then we'll use the charcoal to actually cook it. I'll do it on this side here on a tray so you can see it and keep up with everything. So we're letting this warm up a little bit. Get ready to throw some butter in. What we're going to do is we're going to get this butter to go around. We want to coat everything really good because this is going to be really sticky and lots of sugar that can burn to the bottom of this real easily and make it really hard to clean. So we want to make sure we get good coverage so that it comes apart easy and cleans up easy when we're done. I would usually outside, I'll do if I'm not sauteing, usually that's when I use the cans, I'm doing a large group or something. When I'm using multiple of these, I'll have like three or four of these Dutch ovens going. So I'll line them with foil and I'll use my fresh apples for the filler, and then I'll use apple pie filling as well to make it faster and easier to do larger group. But my preferred method is to do it all fresh. And then what we do is saute down. It can make a difference in the flavors and everything. All right, so we got this melted down pretty good right now, so let's dump in our apples. And basically, we're going to keep stirring this down, let them cook for a little bit, let them saute. We'll put the lid on this. Let it get hot, let it cook, and we'll stir it every so often until they're good and cooked down and soft. And then we'll transfer it and we'll do it. I'm also going to start my charcoal and get my charcoal ready. I'm going to be using lump charcoal, which is actually harder to use than like Kingsford or regular briquettes. These Dutch ovens are actually, there's an actual temperature guide you can use by using briquettes, where it tells you how many to put on top and how many to put on the bottom to maintain a certain temperature. So this one I'm going to be doing, because these are all different. If you've ever dealt with lump charcoal, some are heavier, which means they're denser than others, which means they'll put off more heat for longer than some of the lighter ones. So you have to be careful when using lump charcoal when you're doing this, because the temperatures will vary and how many you have to put on top and how many you have to put on bottom. So it could be finicky when it comes to making sure it gets cooked thoroughly, doesn't burn on the bottom, and doesn't burn on the top before it's all done. So just as something to keep in mind. But anyway, we'll get back to it in just a minute. All right, so now you can see that the color is starting to change on the apples. Starting to get a little more translucent. The color's changing on the red as well. So now that they're starting to get soft, they've been cooking for a little bit. They're not all the way cooked down yet, but now we're gonna add our brown sugar. And I'm eyeballing it. As I do with most things, I just use feeling. As Uncle Roger would say, use feeling. You use it till your ancestors tell you to stop. Now we're going to stir that around. We want to make sure it coats everything. And we're going to let this get cooked down a little bit more until they're almost transparent. Because we don't want that sugar to burn while we're in here sauteing. That's why we add it just before it's done. All right, so I've just turned off the heat. I added a little bit of ginger ale to help steam it a little bit, to kind of help it out, maybe 2 tablespoons worth of ginger ale in here, because that's what we're looking for right there. That's what we want to see, more of that. But I've turned the heat down. It's going to continue to cook as we wait for this to cool down. I'm going to start the charcoal, and I'm going to add the fresh cut apples to this. And then I will show you how we build it up from here. All right, we've pulled this off the heat, and you see everything's good and soft now. There's a little bit of hardness to it, but that'll cook out some too while it cooks in the butter and then in the juices and stuff. So we're going to spread this around a little bit. We're going to add our fresh apples to it. Mix it up a little bit. All right. So this will provide some crunch, and the other apples will provide nice soft texture as well. All right, so now the easy part, building this thing up. Now that we've got it all the apples, our fillings in here, we're going to take our cinnamon swirl mix, and you have the cake mix and then the cinnamon stuff. Throw the box away. Don't need the directions anymore. All right, so we're gonna take this cake mix. Now, if you're gonna add more apples, you will have more filling, you wanna add more bread, more cake mix, if you will, because you wanna make sure you have the ratios right. Some of the people complain there wasn't enough breading in some of my cobblers. But I was also, when I first started, I wasn't feeding 120 people like I was the last couple of nights that I was making it. So I had to increase the ratios. I had to increase the number of apples and fill this thing almost all the way full. But we're only doing about half this Dutch oven. So now we're gonna sprinkle this cake mix in, dry, not mixing it up with anything. We're gonna do that right there. And then we're gonna kind of move it around, even this out, make it nice and flat. All right. And then we're gonna take the cinnamon mixture. And we're gonna spread it around as evenly as we can. And we're gonna take some of our butter. And we're going to place it in thin pieces everywhere. In here, spread it out. You can use less butter, but fat is flavor and butter is fat. And it adds a creaminess to the this. So, and this brown sugar is in here has cinnamon mixed in it. If you wanted to use something, I've used something like a cake mix before, like a yellow cake mix, but you have to add brown sugar and you have to add cinnamon as well. So I think that's gonna be enough butter for now. Now we're gonna get to the ginger ale part. We gotta make sure we have enough fluid in here. We don't want it too watery, but we want it enough to where that breading will get wet and create a bread texture. Go around and make sure we get the edges to get any of that dried. We want to make sure we cover anything at all so that none of it can be dry. Won't be any dry spots on it because we're not going to stir this once it gets cooking. This is how it's going to go. Going to go in the lid's going to go on it and the lid will stay on it only to come off and get checked. So I've got one can in there, or two cans in there, I'm sorry, and I've got about a half a can there. That should be a gracious plenty. Now you can use the rest of that can for a cocktail like I have done. All right, so lid's going to go on. We have our charcoal going, and then we'll when the charcoal's ready, I'll show you what it looks like. Okay, so I've put some of this charcoal down on the tray here. I'm doing this a little unconventional. I would do this on concrete, or I would do it in a foil pan on the ground, but I'm doing this so I can get good coverage for the video, so you can get good eyeballs on it in a fairly neat environment. So now we're gonna put the Dutch oven on top of it. Those legs help provide a little bit of the airflow underneath it, and we can always pick it up and add more coals later. Now we're gonna add charcoal to the top. And you always wanna add more on top than what you think you need, because the top, the heat has to go down, and heat rises, it doesn't go down. So you wanna heat this cast iron up good, so that way it can provide the necessary baking that it needs from the top. But we want to be careful not to put too much heat on it where it burns it. So we're going to check periodically, turn the lid and the base around so that way you don't get any cold spots or hot spots. So we're going to let this sit for a minute and let it cook. We'll check it about 15 minutes. Hey, so I want to sit down while we're waiting on this to cook. We got this on. We got about 10 minutes. We got to check on it in about 10 minutes. But while I have you, I want to talk to you about an organization called Round Canopy Parachute Team. Now, I'm going to try to keep this channel where we talk about food and time and service, but I also want to mention some great organizations out there that are taking care of veterans, helping veterans get together and socialize and really get back that esprit de corps that you had from your time in service. Round Canopy Parachute Team is based out of Palatka, Florida. It is an organization that is centered around honoring all those who've served in the paratrooping field, whether it be all your guys that were from World War II, you know, the paratroopers, they're from all the different types of jobs they had, for the different units, honoring the boys of 44, as they say, but also any current military group that does parachuting, whether it be your pararescue guys or whether it be, you know, 82nd Airborne, Special Forces guys, all those guys who go out and get their jump wings and do service through that. So we're trying to honor those. We've honored people from Grenada, Panama, Vietnam, Korea, and World War II. But you get an opportunity by joining the team. You can come down, go through the jump school or airborne refresher if you already have been through jump school. You can go through a refresher course, earn your RCPT USA wings, and participate in events and jump out of C-47s. We've jumped out of CASAs, caravans, but you're jumping with a round steerable canopy. It's an opportunity to hang out with fellow paratroopers and even civilians or other military members if you didn't get a chance to go through jump school, didn't get a chance to be in an airborne unit, but you served in the military. Come out, join us. If you're active and you're in Air Force, Marines, Coast Guard, you can come through our jump school and possibly get your jump wings to wear on your uniform or be eligible for jump status within a unit within your organization. But that's a different story. That you need to talk to the guys more about that know more, the jump masters that know more. But we have a great group of jump masters. Our club president, Bill Markham, is an amazing individual, amazing human being, one of the guys in the airborne community that is just exceeding in his attention to detail and his love for round canopies is Art Schaefer. He's well known in the square canopy world, but he's branched off in the rounds with us and is just a great inspiration. Does a lot of tandem jumps with veterans. But this year we're going to the 80th anniversary of D-Day in Normandy. I will be going, my brother and many others. This will be probably one of the biggest events for the anniversary in a long time. I wish we could share it with everyone. I wish that everyone could go. But there's only so many aircraft going over. There's only so many slots. So the chances are very slim, if you haven't heard of it already, that you're going to be able to get in. But you can come watch, come visit for this event. There will be jumps in England and in France. There will be some cross-channel jumps where we'll be flying from France to England and England to France to jump. Be great opportunity. But I've done some cooking for the group on the social evenings during the training events they have during the year. And I've been down there when someone else was cooking, and it's just an opportunity for us to get together around and have food and fellowship in the evenings and just talk about all of our experiences, whether you're Vietnam, whether you're Afghanistan, Iraq, whether you're European theater, never saw that, whether you spent time in Korea, whatever it is, whether you were Special Forces and spent time in Djibouti, Djibouti, Africa. What a name. But rcptusa.org, Round Canopy Parachute Team USA. Great organization. If anything else, check it out and donate to help those that can't afford to go through the course to be able to come down, those suffering with PTSD, those who never thought they'd be able to jump again. There might be an opportunity. We might be able to get them in to get them jump. We do intentional water jumps. Those are very easy on the back if you have injuries. Just things to keep in mind. Round Canopy Parachute Team. Great organization. Now, I've shared all I need to share about that. Gone on and on. Let's check on this and we'll get back to it. All right, so we're going to check on this and make sure it's not, that we don't have too much heat on the top. Now that's had a moment, had about 15 minutes to get cooking. Oh, it's already starting to bubble a little bit. That's good. Good sign. All right, so we're good on the heat. So I'm going to rotate the lid. about 90 degrees. And then I'm going to rotate the Dutch oven. It's heavy, about the same, 90 degrees. And that'll help prevent hot spots and help it cook evenly on the bottom. So we'll keep doing that every 15 minutes. So, and it'll probably take about 45 minutes for it to fully cook. And we'll check on it again in 15 minutes, and we'll see where we finish out at. I'll just keep doing this, and then I'll let you see the finished result. All right. So now's the moment of truth. You get to see the big reveal. Look at that. Man. Smells amazing. So I'm going to plate this up, and we'll get a look at it. This looks really, really good. All right, let's serve some of this up. Oh yeah, get some of that bread. And of course, gotta have some Bluebell ice cream. Just look at that. Oh, that's gonna be really good. All right, so let's get into this a little bit and let's taste this. Give it a second to cool just a little bit because it was screaming hot. Get a little bit of that ice cream. Oh, taste the cinnamon, taste the apple. Got a little bit of crunch, but then you also have soft apple in there. Try some of the breading over here with a little bit of apple. Got that sweet doughy breadness. You can taste the butter. Oh wow. That is a treat. They don't call me, and this is around kind of a parachute team guys calling me this. They don't call me the king of cobbler for nothing. That's good, man. Well, you can do this at home in your oven, but it's not near as good as doing it in a Dutch oven outside with charcoal. I'm just telling you. Go out, buy one, try it. Try it. You can line it with foil to keep it from doing it, and you can use the cans. Go easy, simple. Just try it, this method. You will not be disappointed. I guarantee you, you will have a good time. It'll be good. Your family will love it. All right. Well, thank you guys. Like and subscribe. And if you have a story that relates to cooking or food in the military, or something funny, something bad, something good, great, excellent, whatever it is, share it with me. I would love to hear about it. And I would also love to maybe share that in the next video. So, but for now, goodbye. Thanks for joining us on my chow line.